Hey guys, welcome to this another video where we'll be talking about the gas laws. Now, what are gas laws? Gas laws basically dictate how different state variables such as volume, such as pressure, temperature affect gases. So what are the relations between these variables and how do they affect gases? The first one was given by Boyle. Now, what's the statement? It's very simple. At given temperature, the product of pressure of a definite mass of a gas and its volume is constant. So you can say PV is equal to K. Now, what does that mean? That means if you draw a graph on x-axis, if you represent pressure, and on the y-axis, you represent volume, as the pressure increases, the volume decreases. This particular shape of graph is called a hyperbola, right? So how do you put it in equation? Since PV is equal to K, which is a constant here, so we can say if the initial P1 V1 represents the initial state of the gas, then P2 V2 must represent the final state of the gas. So if you change a pressure, the volume will change according to this equation. Why? Because the product of pressure and the volume is constant. There's one more graph that you should be aware of while you talk about the Boyle's law, and that particular graph is where you draw a relation between 1 upon P and volume. So this comes out to be a straight line, right? But remember, whenever we are talking about such conversions, we are saying at a given temperature. That means T is constant here. Now, how can we use this equation to solve some numericals? Let's try to find out. A sample of gas occupies 12 liter under pressure. So you have, the moment you have a question, try to look for the variable. So V1 is 12 liters, P1 is 1.2 atm. So P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Now, you have been told the pressure was increased to 2.4. What would be the volume? The volume is asked, right? So just place the variables 12 times 1.2. You don't know the volume, you only know the pressure. It's 2.4 multiplies, let it just remain as V2. Now, that means, this implies V2 is 1.2 into 1.2. Sorry, 12 into 1.2. And that divided by 2.4. If you do the calculation, it comes to be around 6 liters. Very simple. Now, this related pressure and volume. There's another gap that relates the two quantities of volume and temperature. And again, here the pressure is constant. So volume occupied by a definite mass of a gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature. Now, this is very important. When you say P1, V1 and P2, V2, the only constraint was that the volume, the units used in those cases should be the same, whatever it is. But here, you have to make sure that the temperature that you are putting in is always in Kelvin. Now let us see how that works. So if let's start with a graph. So if we draw a graph and we say the temperature is represented on x-axis and the volume is represented on y-axis, it was found that as we cool the gas, almost always the graph could be extrapolated to minus 273 Kelvin. So as V changes, so V1 upon T1, again, you put the constant that side and bring these this side is equal to V2 by T2. So initial and final. Sounds very easy, right? Let's try a problem on this. So a sample of nitrogen occupies 117 ml V1 at 100 degrees. This is not our T1 because we have to convert this into Kelvin. Remember that. But that will eventually be our T2. Then we have the V2, and at what temperature? Basically, they are asking you to find out the T2. So let's convert our temperature into Kelvin, right? So what's the formula? Degree C plus 273. And how much is that? 100 plus 273? Just about 373. But remember, the question is asking about Celsius. Now, don't be tempted to use the Celsius. It will land you in a mistake. Let's not do that. Okay. So V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2. Now, that means 117 upon 373. Remember, don't get confused between the signs. This implies is equal to, we have been given the V2, that is 234 upon T2, that we didn't know. Now, if you just solve for T2, that comes to be 234373117, and that comes to be about 746 Kelvin. Now, if you just calculate, just you subtract the 273, you get 473 degree Celsius. That's your answer. It's really fun. It's really easy to understand these two gas laws. Here's a question that I want you to practice, and we'll talk about this question in the next video, but have a look. It's actually very easy, and I hope you would be able to do it. See you soon.
We hope you like this video. Press subscribe, thumbs up, and stay geekly.